Everyone, so I'm about to show you a video on how to create this flower here, which I made out of a plastic 2-liter pop bottle. I have tons of these because, yes, I am like a Diet Coke fanatic. So I'm always trying to find different things to do with the pop bottles. And I'm sure everybody has noticed that on the bottom of the pop bottle, it's basically shaped exactly like a flower. Now, I did already do a video showing the process of me creating this, but I noticed as I was cutting the actual flower out that I wasn't in frame very well, so it was kind of hard to see what I was doing. Also, because it's clear plastic, it's a little bit difficult to see. So what I'm going to do is, just as an introduction to the video, sort of, I'm going to show you in more detail how I cut the flower out. So basically I just sawed off the bottom of the pop bottle, for starters, and then I just take a pair of big cheap scissors and I cut down. The center of this is very, very hard. You won't be able to cut into it. These parts here, the petal parts, are softer. So what I'm doing is I'm cutting down the edge closer to the petals so that it's more of a flatter surface, but not cutting so close that I'm wrecking the petals. And you'll kind of feel like where this goes up here, you know, at the top of it, you'll know. You'll have a sense of how far to cut it. See, and it gets harder to cut the closer down you get. So that's pretty much your guide for when to stop cutting. Oops. And just try to make it as even as possible. See, I kind of already screwed it up. Okay, so there's my base for my flower. So now in the video, I'm just going to cut that whole part out since you can't really see it anyway. I'm going to take my Sharpie and I'm going to draw where I made cuts so that you guys can see it a little more, a little easier. So basically what I did was these areas in between the rounded parts right here, I basically cut those out. So as you can see with my Sharpie, just cut a V down like that, and then just round off the corners here on your petals. And do that in between each. Like I said, the closer to the center you get, you can't cut it. So, you know, you'll feel it. You'll be able to do it by feel how far you can go. So just cut it like that and then round off your petals. After doing that to all 5 petals, what you want to do is you want to take your scissors and you want to cut directly down the set. My Sharpie's quitting on me. Down the center of each petal like that. And then take your scissors and round off each petal. And sort of cut like, I hope you guys can see this. My flip cam blurs if you get too close to it. I'm going to get a new camera, I swear. So sort of round off your petals like so, after you've cut them, and then kind of do the same thing where you're able to make a bit of a V in between the petals like that. You see? And do that to all 5 of them. So, yeah. So after you do that, you have 10 petals on the outside of your flower, like this one does. I mean, you can also do it. I've Sharpied all over this one, so I don't think I can use this one, but you can also, I'm trying to figure out what scissors I used the first time to cut these. I can't do it right now because the video would take too long. But you can also do a flower with just the 5 petals. I've not done that. I always cut mine into 10 petals. But there's obviously no logical reason why you couldn't just use 5 petals. Now, the flowers in the middle here, I chose to use Tim Holtz die cuts. And for some reason I can't. Oh, here's one. Which I cut out of the sides of the bottles. And this one is the larger of the die cut. This one's the medium and this one's the tiny. And I just chose to do that because the pop bottle base flower was very large. Whoops. Was very large. So you could put any kind of flower embellishment you want in the middle, but I just chose to do it like that. Also, from the side of the pop bottles, I made my leaves. And I just colored them with Copics, and I purposely made them very streaky looking so that they sort of take on a leaf look. And, oh, here's an example of one of the smaller Tim Holtz die cuts that I did. And so these are done with this just the sides of the pop bottles. And, yeah, so pretty cool. So coming up will be the process of me actually making the flower. I may or may not do a voiceover. It depends. In about 10 seconds, you'll know whether I decided to or not. So I hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching. Bye.